Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, DwyerVIP.com for premium picks. Look us up on Roku in the sports section. We're there, Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. On iTunes, one word, Dwyer Boxing News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now let's talk about week three of the NFL, understanding that right now it's Monday morning and the Monday night football game has not yet taken place. Right? First, to the gamblers, because that's my constituency. Right? Be very careful in analyzing the numbers and then making picks for next week's game between the Raiders and the Dolphins. The Raider defense did look great against the Patriots, but even though some books list the Raiders as the home team, understand that game is going to be played in the United Kingdom, right? That's not really a home game for the Raiders. So keep that in mind before you bet on that Raider-Dolphin matchup. Now here's what leapt out at me. Let me give you a pick for week four out the gate before the line adjusts. I want to focus on that San Francisco 49er versus Arizona Cardinal game. As subscribers here on YouTube know from my prior NFL videos, I'm a skeptic of the San Francisco 49ers. And keep in mind, I'm in the Bay Area. If they were a great team, I'd be one of the first to put money on them. But let me say this. I want you to look at the box score of that 49er versus Arizona Cardinal game, the one the Cardinals won. First, let me say the obvious. The bet I recommended here online in the last video I made before the games kicked off, the under 21 in the first half of that game held. Right? It was a nail-biting, nerve-wracking moment, but the two teams combined for only 20 points. So you should have more money. You should have a winning ticket to cash this morning. But let's go one step further. The 49ers right now are a disaster. I'm surprised that people rate them as highly as they do. All you have to do is, in looking at the box score, look at who the leading rusher for the 49ers was yesterday. You're going to find out that it was Colin Kaepernick. You're going to find out that Kaepernick had 12 rushes for 54 yards. Right? Carlos Hyde had 13 yards rushing the football. Frank Gore had 10 yards rushing the football. Right? I have questions about the San Francisco 49er offensive line. Right? Just look at the numbers. I understand there's some skeptics among you out there. Just look at the numbers yourself. Tell us what you see. I see an offense that is in shambles, right? Let me also point out, too, that this isn't anything new. Because if you look at the 49ers on the season, you're going to find out that there is no game out of the three where the 49ers have even gotten a very modest 22 first downs. Right? They haven't. If you go back and if you look at the first game against the Cowboys, they got 19 first downs. The second game against the Bears, home game, presumably. Right? Home game in their new stadium. In other words, going into that game, the Niners had played as many regular season games at Levi Stadium as had the Chicago Bears, right? In that game, the Niners only had 19 first downs. Yesterday, on the road against the Cardinals, the Niners only had 20 first downs, right? Don't focus on the athleticism of the players. Don't focus on the past Hall of Fame accomplishments of players like Frank Gore. Understand, this team hasn't gotten to, forget 22 first downs in any of the three games, they haven't gotten to 21 first downs in any of the three games. And let me point out, you know, the Dallas Cowboys going into the season were viewed as a defensively challenged team, right? This isn't even the part of their schedule where they play tough defenses like the Seattle Seahawks defense, right? So, you know, all I can say is look at the box score. Also, look at the number of penalties, right? The Niners were penalized 9 times yesterday, 9 times, for more than 100 yards, right? They were penalized 107 yards in yesterday's matchup. The red flags are all over the place. Now, somehow, because of public folklore, because of memories of the last 3 seasons, not this one, but the 3 preceding seasons, the 1-2 Niners are actually favored right now by 4.5 points over the Philadelphia Eagles in a game at Levi Stadium where the Niners officially are 0-1 in the regular season. You've got to be kidding me. Right? What part of the Niner offense do you feel is better than the Eagle offense? It can't be at running back. Right? Not with Hyde getting 13 yards and Frank Gore getting 10 yards. Right? Compare and contrast that to Shady McCoy and Darren Sproles. Right? Also, keep in mind, too, in terms of performance, Philly's coming off of a nice win over a very tough Washington Redskin team, right? Philly's the team with the better record, and you're getting 4.5 points? The first bet I'm recommending for this week is to take Philly on the point spread, take the 4.5 against San Francisco in San Francisco, right? San Fran right now is having problems in all aspects of their offense. Right? Kaepernick is having a problem converting first downs, and they're not running the football. Keep in mind, too, chemistry issues can derail even the most talented of teams. There was a rumor before week 1 that there was some dissension in the locker room in San Francisco, right? And that some players were tuning out the coach. Right? You need to pay attention to that. Understand the Niners have not given Coach Jim Harbaugh a new contract. Right? Understand Coach Harbaugh, who is, in my opinion, one of the best coaches in the National Football League, doesn't have the decision-making authority, the personnel selection authority that coaches like Bill Belichick and Pete Carroll have. Right? So San Francisco could be a powder keg waiting to happen. Let's talk about some other games that happened in week 3. Just a little inventory, a little forensic examination, right? Is there anybody watching this video who still thinks that the Washington Redskins passing attack is better off with RG3 at the helm? You know, a good friend of mine, longtime Redskins supporter, actually texted me during the game. He said, RG3 needs to figure out how to carry a clipboard on the sideline. Right? Because it's clear to both of us, he's a fellow gambler, it's clear to both of us that the Washington Redskins offense works best with Kirk Cousins at quarterback. If you don't know that by now, look at the box score there. The Redskins had over 500 yards of total offense against a team that made the playoffs last year. And this was without them getting 100 rushing yards in the game. Understand that Kirk Cousins threw for 427 yards yesterday. This guy wasn't even your starter the first week. Right? This guy takes over during the season, and now he's putting up ridiculous numbers. Right? The Redskins, by the way, you know, keep in mind, 49ers haven't gotten to 21 first downs in any game this year. The Redskins had 27 yesterday. 27. Let me also say another thing about the Redskins. Look at the defensive numbers. Right? Shady McCoy, Darren Sproles had great weeks the week before. This week, the Redskins limited Philly to 54 yards rushing. 54. Right, so the Skins strike me as a bit of an underrated team. Now, I'm a Giants fan. I'm looking at that Giants-Skins game that's coming up this week. But let's talk about the Giant game for a second. Right? This is really with an angle on the gamblers. Giants won. Great. Hooray. But understand, there are some storm clouds still. While the Giants had over 400 yards of total offense, and that's great, to go with 26 first downs, understand that Houston had over 400 yards of total offense. I want people to look hard at the Texans, right, in this loss. They still generated offense. I know there are questions about the quarterback. I know Andre Johnson's not getting great numbers. Look at DeAndre Hopkins' numbers. Look at the team's numbers. Let me also say, too, they had almost 300 yards passing. They had over 100 yards rushing. Right? So pay close attention to Houston. They're an underrated team. They're not the team that had the first pick in the draft last year. Right? This team looks like they're back to where they were before their recent problems. Now, with regard to the Giants, this is the second time this year that the Giant defense has given up more than 400 yards to the opposing team. Right? That's a problem. The defense is not clicking. Right? They're not clicking and they're about to play Kirk Cousins. That's a big problem. Right? Let me say this in the Giant defense. And it's also an indictment of the Texan defense. Understand the Giants had 193 rushing yards in the game. Right? The Rashad Jennings experiment has worked. The Giants can run the football. Now let me talk about another game. It's a stat you need to know. Seattle versus Denver. You know that balance wins in the NFL. Right? You need a mix where an opposing defense believes you can pass or run the football. Right? If there's an imbalance and your opponent is able to flood the secondary, you're going to have problems. Now, many of you believe that the Denver Broncos are going to win the AFC. Explain to me how they're going to do that when they couldn't even rush for 40 yards. 40. Against the Seattle Seahawks. Right? Don't get distracted by the score. Look at the numbers. They're disturbing. Right? Denver rushed for 36 yards total in an overtime game against the Seattle Seahawks. I thought Denver came into this game looking for revenge for last year's Super Bowl. I thought Denver was all hot and bothered and ready. Instead, they couldn't run the football. Right? Denver, by the way, was held. This juggernaut offense was held to 332 total yards. Right? I believe Denver is a bit imbalanced. I think the rushing game has taken a hit. No Sean Moreno has left. He's now a Dolphin. Right? Denver's not as stacked at the running back position as one would think. Let's talk about another game. Some games are just determined by turnovers. Right? That Giant game, for example, Houston turned over the ball 3 times. Right? Those teams are closer than the score suggested. Well, let's look at the Dallas Cowboys against the Rams. This was a turnover fest. Cowboys turned it over 2 times. Right? The Rams decide to turn it over 3 times. Didn't the turnovers really decide this match? Because isn't it obvious from the numbers that the Rams outplayed the Cowboys, right? The Rams had 7 more first downs. The Rams had 448 total yards. Think about that. Right? This Cowboy defense, let's just say, there's a reason for their bad reputation. This box score is front and center, right? Few people consider the Rams to be an offensive juggernaut. They're supposed to be offensively challenged. This offensively challenged team had over 400 yards of total offense. right? Understand, the Cowboys didn't stop any part of the Ram offense. A lot of passing yards, a lot of rushing yards. They had over 120 rushing yards, right? Sometimes the turnovers decide the outcome. If I'm a Cowboy fan, I'd be nervous. Look at your schedule. You have New Orleans next. That could be a problem. Let's talk about New Orleans. Now, you heard me earlier talk about the 49er offense being challenged. If you want an underrated team, look at these Saints. Did you know that this is the third week in a row? And keep in mind, folks, it's only been 3 weeks to the regular season. This is the third week in a row that the Saints had at least 26 first downs. But let's look at the defense. I know the defense has been vilified of late, and understandably they were playing Minnesota. Not an offensive juggernaut, right? But did you know that they held Minnesota to 59 rushing yards? 59! Did you know they held Minnesota to 13 first downs? Right? So all I'm saying is things are coming together for New Orleans. They're a team to watch. If the defense can just start supporting the offense, this team is going to be, in my opinion, on the right track. Let me say this too. There was a great development in that Minnesota Viking game. Teddy Bridgewater came in the game. Now keep in mind, they're stopping the run cold, right? The Saint defense is geared up to stop the run. But yet Bridgewater comes in, throws the ball 20 times. He's not handing it off. He's throwing the ball. He completes 60% of the passes for 150 yards with no picks. When you see Bridgewater, who's a slender guy, why do you look slender for a quarterback? You understand that his game is mental. He can read defenses, folks, and he's a rookie. He reads defenses, in my opinion, better than at least a third of the starters in the league, the veteran starters, right now. Right? He looked much better than Blake Bortles looked, and Bortles played in the Jacksonville game. Right? I was in a sports bar. I'm telling you, there were some Viking fans at that sports bar. Bridgewater came in. They started yelling Teddy. Then Bridgewater started delivering. This guy's a serious talent. Who knows how he slipped in the draft, right? This guy looks like he's going to be a superstar. You want to keep an eye on him. But do understand, Minnesota's going through a lot, right? I question whether Adrian Peterson ever plays in another game for the Vikings this year, right? Minnesota's having a problem rushing the football, right? Minnesota's offense hasn't been consistently high powered. They're going to have some problems going forward. Let me also say this too, and let me close with this, and it was a bit of a shock. As I said, I'm here in the Bay Area. I was at a sports bar where the Raider game was front and center, right? Let's just say this. I was surprised by how bad the Raider defense made the New England Patriot offense look. Right? Keep in mind, this is a Raider team that Charles Woodson, one of the leaders in the locker room, said sucked of late. Right? That's the word he used. You know, he said, hey, you know, we suck. Right? Well, let me just say this. Did you know that they held Tom Brady to less than 250 yards. In fact, Brady only had a 6.3 yards per completion, yards per passing attempt number, right? He looked lost. Let me tell you, the Patriots only put up 16 points. The game was in New England. They were lucky to win it. Raiders had them on their heels. Derek Carr, who's a talent. Someone's going to have to explain to me how Carr slipped in the draft. Derek Carr hits a guy with the pass. Raiders are in the red zone. ball bounces off of the guy and then is intercepted. Right? Derek Carr looked great down the stretch. The Raiders have found their future quarterback. Raider defense looked inspired. Tom Brady looked befuddled. What was really disturbing was the fact that the players were on the field. Right? Rob Gronkowski was playing. Tom Brady was playing. Shane Vereen was playing. Vince Wilfork was playing. The Patriots had their A-team out there. And they put up less than 20. In fact, less than 17 against the Raiders. And the Raiders were really this close to tying the game. There's a penalty. Call them out of the end zone. You know the rest. Then we end up with the pick. Right? Pay close attention to what's happening in New England. It's a bit shocking, but other than Edelman and Gronkowski, it doesn't look to me like Tom Brady has bonded on the field with other wide receivers. Right? The Patriot offense at this point in September is sputtering. Right? Maybe they'll get it right. Brady's numbers went up over last season, right, as the season progressed. But let's just say there's work to do right now. The Patriots don't look like the Patriots. Now, they got a break in that the Bills lost, right? I believe the Patriots are the best play in football to win their division. But they don't look like they're hitting on all cylinders right now. Anyway, those are my Monday morning thoughts on week 3 of the NFL. Let me hear yours. If there's a story I've overlooked, if there's film we need to look at, if you believe there's a reason for the bad numbers for the San Francisco 49er offense, or the good numbers for the Washington Redskin offense, or if you feel that San Francisco is going to establish some dominance over Chip Kelly and the Eagles, right, in this upcoming game. I like the Eagles plus 4.5 in that game, right? Then leave your thoughts in the comment section to this video. You don't have to agree with me, right? What we're trying to do is really get an edge on the casino. This is about sharing information, all right? Thanks for stopping by. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com and at DwyerVIP.com. Thanks for stopping by.